Hi everybody, my name is Matthias, and today I'm going to show you how you can use multiple audio interfaces in OSX, so you can achieve more inputs and outputs in your DAW. Why not make use of your additional equipment in the studio? Maybe you have some old audio interfaces lying around, and you can get more audio inputs and outputs. Let's take the tour! Right, so in this setup today, we have a complete Audio 6, which is my main audio interface. And we're going to add the Digitact, the Electron Digitact, as a second audio interface. And as our third audio interface, we will add the Steinberg UR22 MK2 audio interface. Right, and the main reason here by adding all these audio interfaces is that we want to have more additional audio inputs and outputs to our setup. And if this was a Windows machine, we would probably have some sync issues, but on Mac OS X, it's really easy to add additional audio interfaces and have that first audio interface as your master sync. So let's see how we set this up in OS X. Right, so first let's open the Audio MIDI Setup application. You actually have two different views here. You have the Show MIDI Studio and you have the Audio Devices setup here. And here we can see a full list of all the audio inputs and outputs on this system. And you can see we have some built-in outputs. And we have a virtual audio interface here called I Show You, which I use to send the audio from the DAW into OBS, which is my video recording software. And you can also see I have an aggregated device set up here. More on that later here. We have a multi-audio device. And the complete Audio 6, which is my main audio interface. And we have the Electron Digitact already hooked up here via the USB to the computer. So let's connect our third interface here. Just another USB cable to our computer. And we should see the Steinberg UR22 MK2 audio interface also pop up here in our list. Now we press this little plus sign here and select create aggregated device. And here we can see all these audio interfaces and we can select which of these we want to use in our merged audio interface. So let's begin by selecting our master audio interface, which is the complete Audio 6 MK2. So we have this one as our master device. Then we will add the Electron Digitact. And we can add the Steinberg UR22. And finally, I will add the I Show You audio capture so that I can send the audio from the DAW into OBS. So here we can see that we have the complete Audio 6, the Electron Digitact, and the Steinberg UR22, and our specific I Show You virtual audio driver. And we can see the amount of inputs and the amount of outputs. And here you can also go ahead and rename these, if you want to rename these to maybe Digi Out 1. Let's say Digi Out 2. And this the red one is our Stein 1, our Steinberg interface, Stein 2. Right, so now you can also see that we have this one set as our master audio device and all these other additional audio interfaces have drift correction applied. That means that we will have our additional audio interfaces syncing up to our main audio interface. Now let's rename this one to Control plus Digi plus Stein. Right, so now let's go into the DAW here, open up our audio settings. This might look a little bit different if you're in Logic, Cubase or Studio One, but I'm using Bitwig Studio here because I really like this DAW. And we can select our device as the input device. Let's select the Control plus Digi, the player now, and select the output device as the Control Digi plus Steinberg. Right, so here you can see that we have all these inputs available. We have 12 inputs available and 12 outputs available. And if we go back to our audio MIDI setup, we can see that the I Show You is the last output device here. So I will select the output bus for I show you driver to these final outputs, the 11 and 12 output. And we will see here in the audio setup, the Digitact, it's number 7 and 8, that's the Digitact. Let's see outputs, yeah, 7 and 8 is the Digitact. So let's do the same thing here, look at our input buses from the Digitact, 7 and 8. So now we have the Digitact as an input there. So if you go into the DAW and look at the audio track, set the input to our Digitact and press play on the Digitact. And we should hear the input from the Digitact. So now we can go ahead and go back to the dashboard and add more monophonic inputs maybe for all these additional inputs. And the same thing for the outputs, maybe add some more stereo outputs. And now all these inputs and outputs are available in our DAW. If you look in the inputs, we have a multitude of inputs. And the same thing goes for our output section here. We will have a sweet collection of outputs. So this is a really, really fast way for you to achieve multiple inputs and outputs, additional inputs and outputs to your DAW. Right, so I think this is a quick way of never running out of inputs and outputs. If you have any old audio interfaces lying around collecting dust, just connect them and add them to your aggregated device here, and you can make use of the inputs and outputs in OSX. Right, so that's one of the main reasons why I'm using OSX, because it's so easy to add additional audio interfaces and merge them and have them sync perfectly here in the aggregated device. Right, you can write any comments or questions in the comments box below. Now you can continue and watch my next episode. My name is Matthias, and see you in the next video. Bye.